Hello everyone, I'm Jyoti Bodas, a Software Development Manager at AWS. Today, I'm so thrilled to demonstrate as how we have optimized our data ingestion process within AWS Supply Chain using generative AI. We all know the challenges that come with integrating data from various sources into a cohesive and centralized data model. It's often a complex puzzle with data scattered across different platforms. That's where our AWS Supply Chain data ingestion pipeline comes into picture, serving as a crucial component in seamlessly unifying such fragmented data. Please join me as we explore the transformative power of generative AI in streamlining this essential aspect of data management. Let's dive in. Today, AWS Supply Chain team is excited to introduce our new generative AI-powered data onboarding agent, which is now available for all our customers. With this release, we are introducing a new concept called Flow that makes it incredibly easy for you to upload customer native data from any source system. Our system then automatically transforms your data and associates to the AWS Supply Chain data model using Amazon Bedrock generative AI solution. Let me walk you through the process, which is essentially streamlined into four simple steps as displayed on the left side of the panel in the screen. Now, step one is to choose your source system where you extract the data. Continue. Step two then allows you to select your AWS Supply Chain modules of interest. For this demo purposes, let's choose Demand Planning module. Below, you'll see embedded documentation detailing the data requirements for the module. For example, demand planning requires product, product alternate, outbound order line, and supplementary time series as an optional entity. You can also give a custom name identifying your source system. I'm going to name it as demand plan. And you can now simply drag and drop the related files. So here I'm dropping outbound order line, product alternate, and product records. We have made it so easy for you to upload the data directly within the web app, mirroring Amazon S3 experience without needing to navigate to S3 console. There is also no need to pre-transform your data to match your data requirements before you upload. Here I have successfully uploaded the data. Now I'm going to click on continue. That takes us to the step 3, which is to confirm your source tables. Here, you'll verify the schema for the uploaded files and delete any unnecessary redundant source tables. Here I can see outbound order line, product alternate, and product related schemas. Now I'm going to accept all and continue, which is where we create the source flows that can now start accepting the data in your source format, including what you just uploaded. Now that brings us to the step 4. This step involves associating your source data with the AWS Supply Chain destination data model using our destination flows. Now here we scan the source tables and column headers of your source data and automatically associate to our destination tables and fields using Amazon Bedrock. Now you'll see the successful association of tables and fields. Here we go. Here is the table mapping and here is the source to destination column mapping, and we also generate the SQL query for it. For any reason, if you want to edit the mappings and override them, you can always simply drag and drop. Here I'm going to override ID to linkage ID, which then immediately changes your SQL. And you can also in inverse change the SQL to map to a different column, say record identifier as ID, save your edits. Now ID becomes record identifier. As you can see, the SQL and mapping are highly responsive. You can also override the table mappings by choosing a different table, which will re-trigger the auto association of the fields for you. Now, once you are satisfied with the mappings, you can go ahead and submit. Like for the product destination flow, I'm going to submit the product. Next, I'm going to submit the product alternate. And I'm going to submit the outbound order line destination flows. Now here at this step, I'm going to complete my step 4, which takes me to a centralized dashboard where you can view the status of your source and destination flows. Here you can see that outbound order line, product and product alternate source flows are in progress. As soon as they are successful, they will trigger the corresponding destination flows into the AWS supply chain data lake. Looks like the source flows are all successful, and that should trigger the corresponding destination flows, which are successful as well for product, product alternate and outbound order line. Now, following these steps through 1 to 4, you're all set for the data ingestion setup. For subsequent data uploads against your flows, you can always go through this one-click upload experience without having to go through steps 1 through 4 again. Or you can have your middleware connector sync the data to your AWS S3 prefix path, as shown here on the screen. For operational purposes, you can always manage your source flows by editing them as well as delete them as needed. The same goes with the destination flows. You can manage or delete the mapping and sequence wherever you need. Now that concludes our demo. Thank you so much for your time. Happy data onboarding.